Good morning, children. As you all know that we have started the second chapter, globe latitudes and longitude. And as we have already done this chapter previously in the month of May, so we are actually going to revise this chapter, and we have started the revision of this chapter in the last period. So in the last period we have come across, or we have tried to understand, that what is globe, as well as various important imaginary lines we have tried to understand. For example, what is axis, equator, these all the things we have understood in the last period. Today we are going to see further. Instead of equator, axis, there are other parallels of latitudes and parallels of longitudes are there, which are also the imaginary lines on the earth. So first of all, we are going to understand that why do we require the longitudes and latitude. See, if we want to locate any place on the globe of the earth, that time, as you can see, the earth is a sphere, or the globe of the earth is sphere. So locating any point onto the globe or a sphere is a difficult task, because you cannot say that earth is that side or this side. On the earth, there's this particular place is that side or this side. So that makes a confusion. So to remove out all this confusion, what the scientists have done, they have made some reference lines on the globe of the earth. And these lines, these imaginary lines, are called as the latitudes and longitude. So how or what are the uses of the latitude to what we actually call the latitude, that first of all we are going to understand. So here, all the parallels from the equator up to the poles are called as parallels of latitude. Latitudes are measured in degrees. So all the horizontal lines that are parallel to each other from the equator to the north pole as well as south pole, both in the both the hemisphere of the earth, is called are called as the parallels of latitude. So latitudes are normally measured, not normally, always measured in degrees. Why in degrees? Because the parallels of latitudes are made on the surface of the globe of the earth from the whatever the center is there in the globe, or from the center of the earth, whatever the angles are getting measured, these angular distances from the center of the earth are marked on the surface of the earth, and then they are marked as the parallels of latitude. So all the parallel lines on the globes in a horizontal way are called as the parallels of latitudes, and these are measured in degrees, degrees of angles, like 0 to 90 north pole and 0 to 90 south pole. In this way, the parallels of latitudes are totally 180 parallels of latitudes are there. Equator represents the 0 degree latitude. As you know, it is in the center of the earth. Since the distance from the equator to either of the poles is 1/4 of the circle around the earth, it will measure of 360 degrees. For example, 90. So as you know very well, that if you will start counting the degrees of the degrees of latitude from the equator, so from here to here you will come to know, from 0 degree equator, from 0 degree equator to 90 degree on the pole, if you will start to count, you will come to know there are 90 degrees. So actually, at any part of the earth, whether it is east or west, you will go, you will get only 90 degree upside and 90 degree downside. But actually, according to the degrees of the angle, there are 360 degrees. So from the side wherever you are counting, the degrees are 90 degrees, and as you will move backside of that, the 90 degrees are that side. So in this way, there are total 180 degrees of latitudes are there on the globe of the earth. And the equator represents the 0 degree latitude, since the distance from the equator to either of the poles is 1/4 of the circle round the earth. It will measure of 360 degree 90, thus 90 degree north latitude marks the north pole, and 90 degree south latitude marks the south pole. As such, all parallels of the equator are called north latitudes. Similarly, all parallels south of the equator are called south latitudes. The value of each latitude is therefore followed by either word north or south. Generally, this is indicated by the letter N or S. For example, both Chandrapur and Maharashtra, India, Belo Horizonte in Brazil, South America, are located on parallel of latitude 20 degree latitude. But the former is 20 degree north of the equator and the latter is 20 degree south of it. We therefore say that Chandrapur is situated at 20 degree north latitude and Belo Horizonte situated at 20 degree south latitude. We see the figure 2.2, that as we move away from the equator, the size of the parallels of latitude decreases. So as you know, there are two hemispheres on the earth, that is north hemisphere and south hemisphere. All the parallels of latitude, those which are north of the equator, are called as the northern latitudes or northern parallels of latitudes, and all the parallels south of the equator are called as the southern parallels of the latitude. Now, if you will take the example of Chandrapur in India, Maharashtra, and Horizonte in the Brazil, South America, you will see both the places, Belo Horizonte and Chandrapur, are on the 20 degree latitude. But you know very well that the Chandrapur is a northern hemisphere, Maharashtra, India is in the northern hemisphere, and the South America is in the southern hemisphere. So to remove the confusion between the northern and southern hemispheres 20 degree or similar latitudes, in each latitude the letter N or S is marked. If the latitudes are from the northern hemisphere, so that time the N letter will be indicated. And if the latitudes are from the southern hemisphere, so S latitude will be indicated over there. So in this way, as you will see, all the parallels of latitude. So as you can see over here, all the parallels of latitudes, if you will see from the equator to northern pole or southern pole, the parallels of latitude start to decrease toward the polar region. Means if you will see the equator is the largest circle, and as you will start to move toward the north pole or south pole, here you will come to know that the length of the or the size of the latitudes are decreasing. So at the pole you will see there is no any latitude, there is a point actually, and this point is actually the 90 degree of the parallel of latitude. But when you will see the map, so there on the map, the 90 degree northern or southern pole or latitude will be drawn as the latitude, not as the point. So this is the difference on the globe as well as on the map. So these are two differences that I've explained to you. Now we are going to see further. Now we are going to see the four important parallels of latitude. There are four important parallels of latitude. Besides equator of 0 degree, the north pole 90 degree north and the south pole 90 degree south, there are four important parallels of latitudes. These are Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, Arctic Circle, Antarctic Circle. These are all four important parallels of latitude. So this is equator that you can see over here. This is equator, 0 degree equator. And as you will come on the northern hemisphere, you will see the Tropic of Cancer. Then after that you will see Arctic Circle. And in this way, these are the two important parallels of latitude in the north. And if you will see south, in the south there are two important parallels of latitude. These are Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle. So in this way, there are four important parallels of latitude which are located on like Tropic of Cancer on 23 degree north, Tropic of Capricorn 23 degree south, Tropic of Arctic Circle is on the 66 degree north of the equator, and Antarctic Circle at 66 degree south of the equator. In this way, these four important parallels of the latitude are located on the 23 degree half north to 66 and half degree north, as well as southern hemisphere 23 and half degrees south, as well as 66 and half degree south. All the four latitude, important parallels of latitudes, are located. And in the next period, we are going to see the different heat zones of the earth. And after understanding the different heat zones of the earth, like torrid zone or the temperate zone, as well as the freezed zone, these are the three we can say the heat zones of the earth. We will understand these heat zones in the next period. Till then, thank you very much.